Alexa. Hey, what time is it? Alexa, pause.
Alexa, pause.
She might go back on.
I know.
She's temperamental sometimes. She doesn't like rum. Hey, welcome to another episode of Tea Time with Brooke and Steve. This is a special edition, National Tequila Day 2024. We got something really good to talk about today. So, welcome to Tea Time with Brooke and Steve and Wally and Quincy Jones.
And Rose are the...
Our new addition to the team here. Here, we're going to talk about another celebrity tequila.
Believe it or not.
We kind of do those. We've done them in the past, but we've learned a lot since we started Tea Time with Brooke and Steve over 2.5 years ago. And we know what tequilas that are made by celebrities are the good ones and which ones are the mediocre ones and which ones to stay away from. We know that now. And, we go to, we use as a reference a lot the Facebook page Tequila 101. Yeah. And every time...
And Tequila Matchmaker. Yeah. Those are two kind of go-tos.
But when there's a discussion about celebrity tequilas, everybody always gets corrected by saying, oh, don't forget number one. And in the beginning, I don't know what number one is. I don't know who the celebrities are. So we're shopping recently in Total Wine down here in Southeast Florida. Beautiful, hot Southeast Florida, and picked up a bottle of Tapatio Reposado, and something else I can't remember, but then I saw way on the bottom shelf, sort of tucked further back than at your feet, was this black bag that had this in it. The black bag was sort of, you really couldn't read it too much, but on the tag, the price tag on the shelf said, number one, $70. And I'm like, is that the celebrity tequila that everyone's talking about? And I quickly looked up on tequilamatchmaker.com, and yes, indeed, it is that number one. They only had the extra añejo, so for $70, I picked it up.
Well, they have two extra añejos. Am I wrong?
Nope.
Okay. And this is the lesser...
Right.
The time still is smaller.
We're getting ahead of ourselves, but they have two extra añejos. One's a 3.5 year extra añejo. The other one's aged 9.5 years. So, but let's kind of go back to the beginning of this brand.
So the history of who's making this actually comes from two owners that are both very, very successful comedians. The first is Alex Reymundo, and the second is Ron White. And they met, at a gig. And then after the gig, they wound up going to the bar and having some shots of tequila. It was around the 1989-ish time period. And they were having shots and laughing a lot and became the best of friends. And the rest is history. They wound up getting together. And Alex is from Acapulco and grew up there until he was 9 or 12 or something like that, and then came to the U.S. And truly grew up in the States. But being Mexican and being, having Acapulco as part of his heritage has never escaped him. So,
Yeah, and he grew up those other years in Kentucky, of all things, and he likes to call himself it's funny, it's his brand of comedy. He calls it Red Mexican. Instead of redneck, red Mexican and Hispanic, because he has kind of adopted, at least for his stand-up persona, sort of a Mexican redneck persona, and his humor blends the two, which kind of goes to how number one got its name. He does this bit in his comedy where he talks about being in love with NASCAR. And he has a made-up driver called Manny Petty, who drives the number one car, which is an uninsured Ford F-150. So it's a whole long bit about being a Mexican in Kentucky, being in love with NASCAR. And I guess he, before they actually named the brand of tequila, they decided to see whether or not that would work with their audience or proposed market. And they hired a marketing firm, and the marketing firm, no, it's never going to work. It's too, kitschy or whatever. And they're like, I don't know, maybe it will work. So they kind of tested it another way with their actual audience, and the actual audience said, we love the name, go with it. So they ditched the marketing firm and stayed with their true tried and true followers of their comedy. They made a really nice brand here, and we're going to try it for you. We've already tried it.
They make a number of different notes. They have a Blanco, a Reposado, and two extra Anejos, but no Anejo.
Yeah, it's interesting.
So, you know, they're believers, which a lot of people are. The longer that you keep it in the barrel, the more flavor and substance it comes. And extra is the way to go. Nothing wrong with that. So how long is this one aged?
Well, you pour. I'll tell you about that. So this particular extra Anejo is aged 3.5 years in white American bourbon barrels, white oak American bourbon barrels. Sorry about that. So it's, and we've already tried it, as you can see, and we're going to try it again in front of you. But it's going to have that real, real long 3.5 year influence on those American oak bourbon barrel notes. So, and that's what we're expecting here. So, salute. Already it's rich.
Gorgeous.
It's rich and complex, like black cherry and chocolates and oak, it's rich. It's rich.
I'm going to go as far as to say that the only thing that I can equate it to is Tears of Verona.
The smell, yeah, for sure.
Smell-wise, so it's very similar to that type of.
Yes. So if you watched our review on Tears of Verona, we described it in short as a very complex notes of aromas and taste that kind of, you know, go beyond that agave taste. It goes to the all the those cherries, the baking spices, the chocolates, the caramels, and all that. And this already has that. So.
Cheers.
Again.
Beautiful.
Yeah. I'm going to say it's not Tears of Verona, but it's damn close, man. You know, for $70 if you can find it. And by the way, I went back the next day and bought two more bottles because I knew I was getting a steal. It's a red Mexican version of the Tears of Verona or whatever. You know, it's good. It's close.
It's additive free. We have confirmation from that. From Tequila Massacre. Totally love it.
So the
deep dark cherry notes. I'm getting chocolate for sure.
And you're getting the sense that it has been aged in a bourbon barrel for a long time. So you do get that. It's not fiery or burnt. There's really no burn to it. But you're not. You know you're drinking a tequila, but it has so much of that influence of that bourbon barrel that. It sort of borders the line, straddles the line between a bourbon tasting spirit and tequila age. And you guys who are bourbon lovers out there, you're gonna love this. You're gonna love this. It's one of those bottles where you open up on the side of a fire or for a movie or something like that, you just sip away.
Yeah. We had a house guest over yesterday.
Yeah.
And we celebrated before Tequila Day. National Tequila Day, and he's a bourbon lover, and tried this, and he's just like, oh my gosh, it's fantastic. So, totally get it.
Yeah. So,
if you find it.
If you can find it.
Yeah, it took us a while to find it.
Well, not that I was looking for it, I stumbled upon it. Yeah. You know, I don't think I've ever seen it there before, and I don't think I've ever seen any of the other expressions of this brand there, and I'm going to look now, because this is really good, and as long as I can find it for $70, for 750 ml, I'm going to continue to buy it. It's that good. I would even
Lots of awards.
They've won a bunch of awards out there. They've been around this brand since 2012, so over 12 years. I would say I would even spend, if I was going to go to like a Christmas party or something like that, if it was $120, $130, I would get it. You know, no need to spend the $300 or $250 or $295 on the Tears of Verona, even though it's 1 liter. This is good. This is really, really, really good.
The one that's aged 9.5, that's an extra Anejo. How much does that go for?
Yeah, good question. It's called Juan in a Million. So they've only made 3,000 bottles of that particular expression, 9.5 years. And you're going to be spending something like $650, $700 for the bottle. I'm not going to spend it, but if any of you out there want to send me a sample or send me a bottle, I'll be more than happy to take it in with white gloves and review it here with Brooke and Wally and Quincy.
Fantastic.
Yeah, this is fantastic.
Comedians can make some good juice.
I would say as far as celebrity tequilas are concerned, this is the best we've ever had. Yeah. Although, to be fair, we haven't had the Blanco or Reposado yet. Maybe we can review that on another episode of Tea Time with Brooke and Steve.
Cheers, everybody.
Cheers. Blue Planet, thank you very much. We love the sunglasses. A great company. Thanks for visiting our website, teatimetequila.com. Thank you, Petco, for the dog toys. Lexa's probably not going to listen to her because she loves me but doesn't like her. Thanks for being a friend. We'll see you next time.
Cheers, everybody.
Cheers, everybody. Alexa, resume. You kind of have to be a little bit stern with her.
Got it.